सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस भगवद गीता चैप्टर नंबर 3 टेक्स्ट नंबर 6। कर्मेन्द्रियाणि संयम्य आस्ते मनसा स्मरन् इन्द्रियार्थान् विमूढात्मा मिथ्याचार स उच्यते। कर्मेन्द्रियाणि संयम्य यास्ते मनसा स्मरण इन्द्रियार्थान् विमूढात्मा मिथ्याचार स उच्यते। कर्मेन्द्रियाणि संयम्य यास्ते मनसा स्मरण इन्द्रियार्थान् विमूढात्मा मिथ्याचारः स उच्यते। प्लीज चैंट। कर्मेन्द्रियाणि संयम्य यास्ते मनसा स्मरण इन्द्रियार्थान् विमूढात्मा मिथ्याचारः स उच्यते। सो यू वांट टू चैंट, व्हाट डू यू वांट टू चैंट? आप लोग बोलना चाहते हैं। कर्मेन्द्रियाणि संयम्य यास्ते मनसा स्मरण इन्द्रियार्थान् विमूढात्मा मिथ्याचारः स उच्यते। You see, in text number 35, the Lord has told that a person, the living entity by default, cannot remain stationary without doing any work. Now, somebody does not listen to the Lord's advice, and the Lord has also mentioned that he will be forced to act by his subhav, which is born from the modes of material nature. Now, in this shloka, the Lord is explaining or kind of chastising a person who does not perform sadhana as per his adhikar. So this shloka is referring to a person who is not qualified for Gyan Yoga. His heart has not become purified by doing prescribed duties, but in an immature way gives up his prescribed duties, and externally he is controlling his karmendriyas, that means his hands and legs and other senses. But then, because his mind is still having a taste for sense objects, he meditates on sense objects even though externally he is not doing things. He is not engaging in sense gratification. Does it make sense? So, what does it mean? Let us understand the shloka. Karmendriyani sanyamya. Karmendriyani is in plural. He is controlling all his external working senses. Ya aste manasasmaran. Yaha means that person, aste. He is remembering the sense objects within his mind. Indriyarthan smaran. How will I be able to satisfy one sense object, another sense object? That's what he's thinking. Vimudatma, that this person is foolish. Mithyachara sa uchite. He is engaged in mithyachara, in show or in cheating. He's cheating. Mithyachara sa uchite. That person is called cheater or pretender, as Prabhupada translates it. If he's not, he knows that his mind is only going on sense objects. But he will just pretend to perform Gyan Yoga. Does it make sense? Okay. One who restrains the senses of action but whose mind dwells on sense objects certainly deludes himself and is called a pretender. Gita Bhushan commentary. But it is seen that there are persons who have closed up their senses like the ear and are therefore devoid of actions of attraction and repulsion. What is the link? In text number 3.5, the Lord has told, Karyate hi vashah karma sarvah prakriti jair gunai. You said that out of being pulled or being pushed by attraction and repulsion for sense objects, a person will be forced to act. Whatever he likes to do, he will do anyways, and whatever he does not like to do, he will not do, even if it is good for him. You remember this point? So now, a person can object. No, he can just control his senses and he will not act as per his attraction and repulsion. But you know that even though he may restrain his external senses, his attraction for sense object is still there. Okay? The sannyasi is a fool who stopping his action senses like the voice still remembers the objects of the senses such as sound by a mind pretending to meditate. He is called an impostor because of remembering sense objects in the mind in spite of not extending the senses outward, which arise because of impurity in the mind through not performing nishkam karma. This ignorant person attempting to control his attraction to material objects does not attain jnana, though he aspires for it. He is thus called a false performer, a pretender. Having false control of his speech and other senses, he is a cheater. So now please hear very carefully. This is applicable to a jnana yogi, not to a bhakti yogi. Don't be discouraged. This is not being told for a bhakti yogi. Because the bhakti yogi is engaging his senses, working and knowledge acquiring senses in Krishna's service. Ko samajh mein aa raha hai main kya bol raha hu? A bhakti yogi is not just simply sitting down and meditating. He is actively engaged in Krishna's service. If you are chanting, that is also active service. Does it make sense? And there is lot of proof in the Shastra which says that even if the mind is going anywhere, If the tongue is chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, then a person gets purified. दिमाग में घुस रहा है, निरुत्साह करने का श्लोक नहीं है. This shloka is applicable for a person who is qualified for karma yoga, but is trying to jump to gyan yoga. I have told several times, for gyan yoga there is a prerequisite, a precondition, that your heart must be purified by prescribed duties of nishkam karma yoga. Samajh mein aa raha hai ki nahi aa raha kuch? But for bhakti, you don't need a pure heart to get purified or all those things. For bhakti, you just directly do bhakti. Hari harati papani dusht chittar api smritah. Lord Hari removes the sin of even those people who are dusht chitta, whose chit is not going to Hari. Nishan mehra. गुणानुवादा खलु सत्व भावना. Now, I am not telling गुणानुवादा खलु सत्व भावना means simply by repeating Hare Krishna, a person becomes purified in his consciousness. Now, what to talk of chanting with attention? But you know that, you understand that you cannot chant with attention if the heart is impure. It will be difficult. So then how the heart will get pure? By keep on chanting, 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 and trying to hear also. And even the chanting itself destroys the impurities of the heart. And the mind goes to Krishna because mind begins to taste Hare Krishna. Hopefully you are not getting discouraged by this shloka. This is, again and again I am telling, applicable to a person who is trying to practice Jnana Yoga. We are not practicing Jnana Yoga here. We engage our senses in Krishna's service. Are you not engaging your ear and mind in hearing about Krishna? I'm using my brain or whatever, mind and my ears and my voice to talk about Krishna. It doesn't make sense. We are not just simply sitting down. It is applicable to a person who just simply sits down and make a show. Is a very great advanced person, a meditator, but he is actually meditating on sense objects. And now, what is the reason why he is meditating on sense objects? Because his heart is not purified. So it would have been better that he would have got purified by performing his duties, and then he can actually take karma sannyas. Does it make sense? Hopefully you are understanding and not getting discouraged. So you see, Prabhupada makes it very clear in the first line itself. There are many pretenders who refuse to work in Krishna consciousness but make a show of meditation while actually dwelling within the mind upon sense enjoyment. Make sense? So one should be very, very honest in terms of what is his adhikar. And he should act as per his adhikar, as explained in the 11th canto by Lord Krishna, that is appreciated by the Lord. If you are qualified for work, you work, but work for Krishna. Now, subtle point of difference is that we are not doing karma yoga. What is technically explained by Shri Rupa Goswami is Krishnartham Akhila Cheshta. What Sanskrit I spoke? Krishnartham Akhila Cheshta. Akhil means all, Cheshta means endeavors, and Krishnartham means for the purpose of Krishna. We are not doing karma yoga. It's not that somebody is cooking for Krishna, is doing karma yoga. Does it make sense? A person is thinking, how I can design a poster for Krishna's preaching. It is not karma yoga. Is it sinking in your heart? It is Cheshta, it is endeavor, by body, by mind and words. वी आर ट्राइंग टू सर्व कृष्ण, दिस इज प्योर डिवोशनल सर्विस. डज इट मेक सेंस व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से? कर्म योगा विल बी कॉल्ड, इट विल बी कॉल्ड कर्म योगा व्हेन अ पर्सन इज नॉट रियली अ डिवोटी राइट नाउ, बट ही गिव्स अ पोर्शन ऑफ हिज इनकम टू सर्विस टू सर्व कृष्ण, बट ही हिमसेल्फ इज नॉट चैंटिंग हरे कृष्ण ऑल दोस थिंग्स, सो ही गिव्स अ पोर्शन ऑफ इट ऑफ वट एवर ही अर्न्स टू कृष्ण. बट अ डिवोटी कैन ऑल्सो अर्न बट यूज हिज लक्ष्मी फॉर डायरेक्ट प्रीचिंग्स, दैट इज भक्ति योगा. डज इट मेक सेंस? सो प्लीज डोंट थिंक दैट इफ यू आर टोल्ड टू डू सम सर्विस, जस्ट लाइक यू आर टोल्ड टू आस्क रिक्वेस्टेड हम्बली रिक्वेस्टेड टू मेक सम पूड़ीज यस्टरडे, सो वर यू डूइंग कर्म योगा? दैट इज भक्ति योगा. डज इट मेक सेंस? मेकिंग पूड़ीज फॉर जगन्नाथ एंड फॉर वैष्णवस, इट इज नॉट कर्म योगा. I was worried about internet yesterday. All this, how the internet will work. Is it karma yoga? No, that is bhakti yoga, because it is behind Maharaj's class, which was supposed to please the devotees and help others. Does it make sense? So it's not that whole day you have to, in the morning, evening, you are doing bhakti yoga and daytime doing karma yoga. Not necessarily. Not necessarily. Samajh mein aa raha hai kuch palle pad raha hai baat kya keh rahi thi? Krishnartham akhil cheshta. I give an example. Just like a person who's a terrorist, he will do so many things for exploding a bomb. He will eat, he will plan, he will do all those things. Is it not? I am not telling anybody to become a terrorist. I'm just giving an example that only thing which is in his mind is how to explode a bomb. Similarly, a devotee's whole life is geared or should be geared in chanting Hare Krishna and spreading Hare Krishna and how he can spread Krishna's glories. Does that, so that is not karma yoga. Okay, so that is bhakti yoga. Such pretenders may also speak on dry philosophy in order to bluff sophisticated followers. But according to this verse, these are the greatest cheaters. You know, very important point. They may pretend to meditate, but they have removed the main object of meditation, which is Krishna. And we have discussed in the second chapter, unless a person is matparha, unless a person's mind is fixed on Krishna, the mind cannot become purified. I am repeating this point. Yukta asita matparha. Unless one engages his senses and mind in Krishna's service, there is no possibility that the mind will get purified. Krishna will not purify your mind. So all these people who teach their students to meditate not on Krishna, and after Krishna, what is there? If Krishna is not there, what is there? Maya. So they are actually training the students to actually meditate on Maya. I give an example. I have given earlier also. One person was invited for this Dhyan Shivar meditation camp, and he was a farmer. And when he was asked, when he came back in the Association of Devotees, what were you meditating upon? I was meditating upon my tube well, which was run. I had left it running, and I was thinking maybe the water is going to my fields. And that's what it happens, and everybody else mostly snores and sleeps. So I remember it was funny. This is amazing, Kali Yuga is amazing. That in Indonesia, I had gone to a seminar to a very so-called very disciplined school. And they were very proud. We are having transcendental meditation for our students. Every day they do transcendental meditation. So I asked the principal, what do you understand by transcendental? He does not even know what is transcendental, and you are so proud that your students are doing transcendental meditation. How do you know what are you transcending? So he says, this kind of ignorance prevails among the leaders, what to talk of the followers. I was explaining, he says, we are a beautiful school. I said, do you think this beautiful school has come by explosion? He was a supporter of Darwin. No. So how can you think that this whole universe is coming by explosion? It was like a shock to him. I mean, he was saying, so the scientists are not telling the truth. I said, what is your logic speaking now? So you see what I'm trying to say, people are this all these transcendental meditators and all those things, they are actually cheating. Why they are cheating? Because they don't know that Krishna has to be meditated upon. Does it make sense? Acha, if you are thinking, how can I serve Krishna in a particular service, are you meditating on Krishna? Yes, because Krishna Seva is not different from Krishna also. And it becomes very natural for a devotee to meditate like this. How will I do that service? How will I do that service? Makes sense? So a devotee does not have to restrain his senses. He is in a practical samadhi. Practical samadhi, samajh rahe? Practical samadhi by thinking how I can serve Krishna, he immediately gets connected to Krishna. He doesn't have to just sit down in one place and just make a show of meditation. Okay? For sense enjoyment, one can act in any capacity of the social order. But if one follows the rules and regulations of his particular status, he can make gradual progress in purifying his existence. So, a person can be a Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, Brahmachari, Grahastha, Vanaprastha, Sannyasi. But the rules and regulations are made in such a way that when a person follows them, he makes gradual progress. But if a person wants to make faster progress, he should take directly to the process of bhakti. Now, what the point is, a devotee still remains situated in Varnashram. Actual devotee. Real pure devotee. But he may behave like a Varnashram person also. But his faith is not on Varnashram. His faith is on devotional service and directly serving Krishna. Is that clear? So he may still be situated as somebody may be in a Grahastha ashram or Brahmachari or whatever. But he understands simply by following these rules, I am not going to get Krishna. Samajh rahe na meri baat? So he disidentifies internally from Varnashram. He may still behave within the Varnashram system. It's a very subtle point to be captured. But he himself simply identifies as servant of the Lord. Chaitanyaradasa moi, Chaitanyaradas, Chaitanyaradasa satara, Sevakiradas. This is the shloka spoken by Advaita Acharyaji. I am servant of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I am servant of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I am servant of Sriman Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I am the servant of Sriman Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is how you should identify. And then we become very happy. Actually very happy. Because we know what we are supposed to do. It is all a matter of identification. Just switch on that identification that I am a servant of Mahaprabhu, Krishna. And I must serve his devotees. That's it. Then life becomes very easy. And as soon as you switch on the flaws, you go, I am whatever, I am this and that, considering regarding the body, then we have so many aspirations and so many things to do materially. But he who makes a show of being a yogi while actually searching for the objects of sense gratification must be called the greatest cheater, even though he sometimes speaks of philosophy. His knowledge has no value because the effects of such a sinful man's knowledge are taken away by the illusory energy of the Lord. Such a pretender's mind is always impure and therefore the show of yogic meditation has no value whatsoever. Is Prabhupada saying about chanting Hare Krishna? No. So again I am repeating because this shloka can be used by some preacher to discourage you. Because we know when we chant Hare Krishna some bad thoughts will also come. And that Srila Prabhupada explained is like boiling ghee. When you boil ghee, so many impurities will come. So we are not chanting Hare Krishna to get meditate on these impurities. We don't want it, is it not? We are trying to hear the Hare Krishna mantra. We are trying to chant the Hare Krishna mantra. And Krishna knows, we are praying to Krishna. Krishna, remove these things. And Krishna is actually removing them. But when you chant Hare Krishna, Krishna is purifying your heart. And that's why all this kachara is coming out. Having thoughts about service during chanting is fine, or simply we should hear, focus on Harinam. This is a question which comes so many times. It's a good question asked to His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj also. He says, there are two answers to it. One is that as far as possible, we should try to chant Hare Krishna and hear Hare Krishna. That is the best. But it is much superior to thinking of sense gratification and chanting Hare Krishna. So if you're thinking about a service, now I asked to Vrindavan Chaitanya Maharaj, he said, very nice. He said, you chant Hare Krishna. And thinking about a service, that's also very nice. I mean, so different versions by different devotees. So, different versions, I cannot say. His guys, Ramakrishna Prabhu simply said, Hari Nam is Agni. Hari Nam is Agni. Hari Nam is fire. It will burn. Don't worry. Just keep on chanting. He was very assuring, don't worry, keep on chanting, it will just go away. By his spice experience like that. So, this is very good. So, if you chant Hare Krishna, if you can chant very attentively, who can chant fully attentively? We preach about it, but am I able to chant 100%? No. Even one Mahamantra you can hear in the whole, one mala, that also will be good. Make sense? So, you keep on chanting and one day, As avidya gets destroyed, then we naturally taste the holy name. And then when we naturally taste the holy name, then we can be 100% focused. So don't expect that it will happen immediately to us. We should keep on chanting. But one thing is definitely sure, if we actually try to chant as attentively as possible, that is very purifying. लॉर्ड हिमसेल्फ हैज टोल्ड, यू नो दिस श्लोका, यदि व्हाट इज इट, मन धावती चंचलम अस्थिरम, यतो धावती मन चंचलम अस्थिरम, वेर एवर द माइंड गोज यू ब्रिंग इट ततो ततयो नियम यतद आत्मन्यम वशम नयेत, यू ब्रिंग इट अंडर योर सेल्फ एंड फोकस ऑन कृष्ण. सो बेस्ट इज टू चैंट हरे कृष्ण एंड हेयर हरे कृष्ण, दैट इज मोस्ट टेस्टफुल. इफ अ पर्सन इमीडिएटली कैन नॉट डू, देन एटलीस्ट यू कैन थिंक अबाउट हिज सर्विस, इज मच बेटर देन थिंक अबाउट सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेशन. ओके, बट आई एम टेलिंग यू, सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेटिव थॉट्स कम इन माई चैंटिंग ऑल्सो, इज नॉट अ माई परमंस. यू सी यमुनाचार्य ऑल्सो सेज दैट इट जस्ट सडनली आई एम रिमेंबरिंग association with woman. It happens with exalted devotees also. Mind is a strange thing. It's like a bubble, you know, it's like a bubble. But you just don't worry about the bubble. What we have to practice is, do not worry about anything, whether thought of sense gratification or anything. Best is to chant attentively. And we have mentioned from Vedanta Sutra, Asin Sambhavat. What Sanskrit I spoke?
Asin.
What did I speak?
Asin
Sambhavat. That meditation on the Lord is possible when you sit down and chant, meditate. So there is no rule for chanting. You can chant in any way, but you will actually see that if you start practicing to sit at one place and chant, it really is beneficial. I'm personally seeing it becomes so easy to chant 16 rounds. I did not have any kind of sleep all night yesterday. And still it was so easy to chant 16 rounds. I feel so happy to have a session of so many devotees on Zoom. People think that I am giving more time to Zoom people like that. No, I am doing it for my own happiness. It is so easy to chant. So I recommend devotees actually sit alone and chant with the session of devotees on Zoom. Nobody disturbs you. There is no distraction. Every day you are sitting in the same situation. I don't see right. I don't see left. What right? That is a very great advantage. Your atmosphere does not change. Is it not an issue you must be experiencing? You don't have anything to look now. And every time you look at some devotees are enthusiastically chanting. I mean, personally for me, it is helping me so much in my chanting. All these 13 years, I mean, Zoom kaha tha? You know what I know. It's so regular. No sleep. Did you saw me sleeping today? Practically whole night, the mosquitoes were, Mahaprasad, they go in there. Yes. They were eating my flesh today, but just could not sleep. But it was amazing. And Sudama Prabhu told me also, he was giving class till 12 a.m. 12 a.m. then? 12 a.m. in night. And then he was chanting with devotees. I said, no sleep. I don't know what is a mystic potency behind all this thing, but it's amazing. Anyhow, so this helps us. Devotees help us to. You will see in the commentaries later on, the Lord does not deprecate a devotee if he has lusty desires and all those things. And that has been corroborated in by Shukdev Goswami. Ichchatam akuto bhayam. If a person is desirous of material things, is still harir namanu kirtanam. Yogi nam nirnitam harir namanu kirtanam. So if you have material desires, naturally the mind will go to material desires. Still Shukdev Goswami says, no, very good if you chant Krishna's name. Again, it is said, thinking of Krishna or Vishnu is very difficult, but chanting is very easy because simply by vibration of the lips and tongues, the sense get destroyed. Is it going into your head or not?
Yes.
Very difficult to get. Baat samajh mein nahi aati. Simply by chanting means simply by chanting. What to talk? You have no katham kya tha? Katham api sakradatam muktidam praninamyat. We see also about Ajamil. His mind was on his son. Does it make sense? So again, I'm repeating. The Lord is telling it for a Gyan Yogi, not for a Bhakti Yogi. ठीक है? And we also hear from Bhagavatam, when a person develops taste for Krishna Katha, he may still be having infections of lower modes of material nature. Do you remember? But as he develops a taste for hearing about Krishna, Krishna clears all these lower modes of material nature. Then एवं प्रसन्न मनसो भगवत भक्ति योगतः भगवत तत्व विज्ञान मुक्त सनंग सजायते. सो इट्स नॉट एक्सपेक्टेड दैट यू फर्स्ट प्यूरिफाई योर हार्ट एंड देन यू कम टू भक्ति योग. सिंपली बाय हियरिंग अबाउट कृष्णा एंड एन ईगरनेस टू हियर अबाउट कृष्णा. एंड आई सी ऑन ऑल यू ऑल द डिवोटीज देर इज एन ईगरनेस टू हियर अबाउट कृष्णा. कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ विल क्लियर ऑल द थिंग्स इन द हार्ट, विच यू विल सी इन भगवद गीता ऑल्सो. in 10th chapter, Krishna is told by Arjuna, oh, he is just about to fight the war. He says, I am hearing your glories from your mouth. I feel so nice. I so feel so nice. So, like you understand? So, we don't simply restrain our senses. We engage our senses in Krishna service. So, this shloka is not applicable to bhakti yogis. And Prabhupada clarified in the first line itself. And now, the Lord appreciates a person who actually engages his senses in Krishna service in this 3.7. So, a person who just tried to restrain his senses and his mind is meditating on sense object, Krishna does not appreciate. Even for a devotee also, in one sense, he is saying, he may externally say, I am doing mansik seva. Do you have adhikar for mansik seva? Maharaj, one time His Holiness Vrindavan Chand Maharaj bolte, mansik seva ka koi bharosa nahi hai. We don't have really faith on mansik seva. It's very exalted. You know, you can't just sit down and think of Krishna. As you sit down and either I'll think of woman, I'll think of money, or I'll think of sleeping. Is it not? Dekhi rahe na. So even bhakti also, you do as per, right now, first important thing is to do your bhakti with the senses. Don't start thinking about mind only. Okay. Yastu indriyani manasa niyamarabhate arjuna karmendriyai karma yogam asaktahasa vishishyate yah Tu indriyani manasa niyamarabhate arjuna. O Arjuna, but that person, but is distinguishing this person who is engaging his senses in Krishna's service from the person who is only trying to meditate and only trying to restrain senses. Does it make sense? Yahtu, but that person who by his mind controls his senses. Indriyani manasa Niyam arabhate. Niyam means control. And arabhate, he begins to control his senses through his mind. Obviously, you understand, all the senses are controlled by the mind. So, the mind, if he makes a determination, I will serve Krishna in bhakti yogi context or in a karma yogi. Okay, I'll perform my action as a matter of duty and I will not desire fruitive results from this duty. Okay? And in this way, he engages his senses in karma yoga or bhakti yoga, you understand these things, then he becomes purifier in his heart. So say karmendriya karma yogam. He performs karma yoga by his karmendriyas, by his action performing senses, by his speech, by his hands, by his legs. Does it make sense? You understand karmendriyas, by which you do something? Asaktaha savashishyate. But he is not attached. Asakta, he is not attached to the fruit which will come from that action. I have explained again, I am explaining again. And a person who is doing karma yoga, he will do some varnashram activities or whatever prescribed duties and he can do it for gaining sarga. But a person here is referred to as asakta, who is unattached. He is not attached to going to sarga. He wants, sarga means heavenly planets, he wants to purify his heart. Freeze ho gaya. Chala gaya. Very nice. That is expected from our dear. Okay, so a person who is, so you understood this shloka? A person is much superior to a false meditator. Who is that person who is superior? A person who engages his senses in Krishna's service. On the other hand, if a sincere person tries to control the active senses by the mind and begins karma yoga in Krishna consciousness, without attachment, he is by far superior. Attachment to? Without attachment to? The results which will come from that action. Okay. Gita Bhushan commentary. On the other hand, the householders who performed his prescribed activities is better. He is better to a sannyasi who has not purified his heart and trying to be a false sannyasi. He is not trying to be a false sannyasi. He is a false sannyasi. He is trying to show that he is a sannyasi. That is the point. Now, please hear clearly. It is not being mentioned that sannyasi is less than grahasthas. A person who is not qualified for sannyas and trying to behave like that is lesser than a grahastha. Okay. That person is superior who, devoid of desire for the results, asakta, performs the method, yogam, in the form of actions, karma, by the action senses with regulations of those senses by the mind, which has the intention of realizing Atma. Did I mention all these things? By the mind, with the object of realizing the self, the Atma, the Karma Yogi will perform actions of Varnashram, but not with attachment to the results which will come from those actions. I think now it is very clear. And in that way, his heart becomes purified. This is very, very important. Don't think it doesn't apply to Bhakti Yoga. In Bhakti Yoga, your intention has to be, makes a lot of difference, is it not? Am I doing chanting Hare Krishna to gain public opinion or whatever, all those things? Or I'm really chanting Hare Krishna to purify my heart? This makes a lot of difference. But what intention I'm doing Bhakti? And Bhakti is powerful, but if your intention is to please the Lord and the Lord, please purify my heart very quickly, with this kind of prayerful attitude we do, then also we see that there's a difference in Bhakti, is it not? What is that? Advancement in Krishna consciousness depends on the attitude of the follower. We read from Upadeshamrita. He is better than a person acting on the platform of Jnana, which is only to be achieved in the future. So the idea is, the person who is doing Karma Yoga, he will naturally be elevated to the platform of Jnana, in which he realizes himself distinct from the body. But a person who is not in that consciousness, not purified, and is just trying to behave, then and his mind will only go into sense object, that person is not good. Perfect. Instead of becoming a pseudo-transcendentalist for the sake of wanton living and sense enjoyment, it is far better to remain in one's own business and execute the purpose of life, which is to get free from material bondage and enter into the kingdom of God. This is, Hare Krishna, yes? Awaaz nahi aa rahi? Echo? Echo kaise ho jayega? Bas mic to change nahi kiya hu. Echo. Oh. Now is okay? I think my Zoom has some consciousness. Automatically it changed something. I did not do anything. I did not do nothing. In American language they say like this. I did not do nothing. Anyways. Okay. So much complaint. They are such a big complainers. 16 complaints. Okay. I understand. So, where we were. Now, this is actually a very good thing. And although many times I've been heavy, but now I'm realizing it. For most people, the preferred ashram is Grihastha ashram. Most people. Now, I'm not saying to you or to you, but to anybody, but what is your choice, you choose. But do not be a Grihamedhi. Oh, Prabhuji, now that person has got married, I cannot wake up for Mangal Arati, I cannot chant Japa. If you feel comfortable in Grihastha ashram, fine. Obviously, most of the people feel comfortable. And people may have different opinion, he may have different opinion about me or whatever. I want to preach to anyone who's interested, whether he's a student, whether he's a Grihastha, whether he's a Mataji or not a Mataji. Only thing I want, and it becomes very easy to preach to a person who is materially little comfortable. You understand my point? If he's in anxiety, how to get a job, you tell him to join two rounds. No, Prabhuji, job lagega, job nahi lagega. Somehow that endeavor doesn't go. Uska hriday mein ghusta nahi hai baat. So this has worked very amazing. I just came to know our Prabhuji's sister, Rekha Mataji. Rekha Mataji, she wakes up 2 a.m. and chants Hare Krishna. Today Prabhuji told about it. Just Prabhuji told Mataji and she was so enthusiastic. You understand? And through online preaching, we easily get students and Matajis and Prabhujis who are all very enthusiastic. And Vikas Kohli Prabhu is bang on target from next day on. Mangal Arati Japa is amazing. So what I'm trying to say, you find where you feel comfortable. I will now not tell you become brahmachari, don't become brahmachari like this. Where you find comfortable, where aapko kahan pe theek se lagta hai ki hum tracker jee sakte hain. But grihe thako vane thako sada hari bole thako, where you can chant Hare Krishna peacefully. Samajh, this is a siddhant. Jiska grihastha ka sanskar hota hai, wo grihastha banega hi, chahe kitna hi aap preaching kar lijiye. A person who has an attitude of becoming a grihastha or impressions of becoming a grihastha, he will 100% become grihastha. A person who has an attitude of brahmachari, you tell him no matter you the glories of grihastha ashram, he won't be affected. No. Who cares? Useless. So, kaun dimag kharab karega? So, he will remain a brahmachari. I have seen it just never works. It just never works for anybody. No, this kind of preaching doesn't work. But wherever you are situated, you find, you apna dimag lagaiye, how can I chant nicely Hare Krishna mantra and go back to God? How can I follow four regulative principles? This is very, very nice shloka. Does it make sense? And become free from material bondage. At least morning and evening should be exclusively for hearing and chanting. I mean, I must tell you, yesterday when I heard Maharaj's lecture, I became immediately enthusiastic to read the commentaries. I started reading, Sanatan Goswami commentary and then said, itna reh gaya padhne ke liye. It's so much to read now. Is it not? Itna kuch reh gaya to relish and to... So that is the advantage of not getting married. You have so much time to practice Krishna consciousness. But if a person is still not convinced, he can still be in little bit of Maya and still practice Krishna consciousness. But wherever you feel comfortable. Where acha lag raha hai sunne mein. I know. That's why I'm speaking. Just to get more views. The prime swarth gati or goal of self-interest is to reach Vishnu. The whole institution of Varna and Ashram is designed to help us reach this goal of life. A householder can also reach this destination by regulated service in Krishna consciousness. So I was not speaking something out of the context, but what pains me, it says, Prabhuji, ab bachcha ho gaya hai to uth nahi sakte. I have a kid now and I cannot wake up in the morning. That is not Varnashram. But one funny thing is, when Brahmana was saying, Vedas do not tell that when the child cries in the morning, when the child cries, from where does it come? Oh, every day I'm having these insects. From there. Anyways. So, he was telling a funny comment. Vedas may give you so many prescriptions. Do this in this situation. Do this in this situation. But they do not say, what if your child cries in the night, what you should do. And obviously, there is no prescription. What you will do? And if he cries twice, then what you should do? This is amazing. Means you have to wake up and take care of the child. So if a person is intelligent and doesn't want to be bothered with these things, he can practice Krishna consciousness. He means she also. He can practice Krishna consciousness undisturbed. At least some years in your life, you should practice nicely so that you remember, I practiced nicely. Now I am not able to. At least itna itna to hona chahiye. Hai na? So it is possible through Zoom. Online you can connect with us every day. But... Just R.S. Yes, Shubham Prabhu yesterday say, life to yahi hai. Very good realization. This is the life. Why I should worry so much, work so hard so much, is it not? So that's how, if you have very good sadhana, and you see, I don't know how much devotees can appreciate, this all Maharaj lecture is arranged by Krishna. It's all arranged by Krishna. Don't think it's just by some accident or something, it's nothing. When you chant Hare Krishna, Krishna arranges association of great Vaishnavas with you. Just, there is no other explanation. We had no idea when Maharaj went to give class about his giving, nothing. And Maharaj agreed also. And it's good that net is not working here. Whatever. Then Maharaj is coming there to give class. So I'm just saying, you will see in your life, whatever knowledge is needed, if you keep on, even read search for Krishna, Krishna will make arrangements. He will make arrangements for association of devotees, everything. Okay. So, householder can also reach this destination by regulated service. For self-realization, one can live a controlled life as prescribed in the Shastras and continue carrying out his business without attachment and in that way make progress. A very important point, I'm talking only directly talking about Krishna conscious iskon grihastha devotees. Their goal of life should not be sense gratification or to imitate the outside grihasthas who have big cars and big everything. And they have then their time for Krishna consciousness will not be there. Make sense? So even if a person wants to enter into grihastha ashram, he should plan that I will also come out of this grihastha ashram from after 50 years of age. So this is one point. And second, while being in grihastha ashram, that person should be very much focused, having very good sadhana in the morning and evening. Unless that plan is there, we are landing in a very dangerous zone. We must remember, if we are simply chanting 16 rounds and not hearing anything, we will not be able to chant 16 rounds also. So there has to be a full program where we can hear about Krishna regularly, morning, evening, chant 16 rounds. Basically follow the morning program and evening program. Then, okay. Otherwise, in a very dangerous zone. Very dangerous zone. A sincere person who follows this method is far better situated than the false pretender who adopts show bottle spiritualism to cheat the innocent public. You know what is show bottle? Show bottle is put in a medicine shop with it, there is no medicine, only just for show. Prabhupada used to say this. This weed bag is not for keeping the hands warm. Haath garam karne ke liye nahi hai. Haath garam rakhne ke liye nahi hai. It is for actually chanting Hare Krishna. So a person who is, there are some people also, I won't tell them, call them ISKCON devotees, but they are so-called people who may be so, in a so-called way ISKCON devotees, but they don't chant Hare Krishna. They don't chant Japa. So they are show bottle people. We don't want to be like this. Bhaktivinoda Thakur becomes more heavy. In his, he has Kanthi and he has Tilak, but he is Kali Chela. He does not follow any rules and regulations. So that kind of person we don't want to, although you are all sincere devotees, I am not talking to you, but I am saying we should be very sincere devotees. And you will see actually if you chant 16 rounds, follow four regulated principles, we actually feel the advancement in Krishna consciousness. We feel detachment from the material world, is it not? Yeah. So, a sincere sweeper in the street is far better than the charlatan meditator who meditates only for the sake of making a living. Yes, this is extremely important. Even when worshipping Krishna, there may be some people, there are some people who will worship the deity just to get money from the followers, from the people, and put the money in the pocket. That is very bad. It is, example is given, cracking almond by Shaligram. One pujari was worshipping Shaligram. It is a story told by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Thakurji. And his only desire was to gain money by that worship. People will come and give some money. So one day he had an almond and he wanted to break the almond to eat the almond. Almond, so much, badam. So his external shell is very strong. So he said, oh, I have no stone. What should I do? Oh, the Shaligram is good. With Shaligram, he was trying to break that almond. So you understand? This is the meaning. So we should not be like this. And if there are more and more sincere devotees, more and more sincere people will join. You also be very, very careful about this. If we remain sincere in Krishna consciousness, people, Krishna will send more and more sincere people to join your company. He will inspire them from their heart, from within the heart. And you see how so many sincere devotees are joining every day. Today almost 100 devotees were there for chanting Japa. And it's like repetition, you know, every day they are chanting, coming like that. You will see in your life, you just remain sincere and serious in chanting Hare Krishna and with the desire to preach Krishna consciousness, and you will find so many people. No, you also have some friends, then three or four friends were chanting Hare Krishna. If they had no desire, why will they come to chant Hare Krishna? So be situated, sthane sthaha shruti gatam. You be situated in your position and hear about Krishna. But I have an objection. Some of my students are saying, so Prabhuji is already giving class now online. Why should we need to come to Vrindavan? Fine. But are you able to come to on Zoom also? Some of them are dropping on Zoom also, is it not? I don't want to take names. But all those people who are saying this, they are not able to come on Zoom also. We have no problem. Come on Zoom and chant Hare Krishna with us. Are you able to do that also? I'm talking about, obviously they are not hearing because they are not in the class today. So, but that's a fact. So you have to, so every one of us has to find his own way to survive in Krishna consciousness. In which social atmosphere, everywhere. Like our Prabhu, what is, I forgot your name. Ranshwar Prabhu was finding difficulty in Vrindavan to stay outside and practice Krishna consciousness. Yes?
Rising up early.
That's the whole point. Rising up early and then practice bhakti. After you rise up early, then what is the difficulty in bhakti? Okay, so let's say he was, for morning sadhana, he was finding difficulty. He was intelligent. He immediately made a choice and he discussed with me and then he said, why don't you stay in Govind Nivas? So he's staying in an ashram atmosphere. Every day you are coming for Mangal Arati. So, itna buddhi hona chahiye na ki meri bhakti kyon kahan dikkat ho rahi hai. Itni buddhi honi chahiye. I must have this intelligence. Why I am not able to do my sadhana? And how can I get help from the devotees and improve it? So, that everybody has to find out on his own. All these devotees are doing in that way. Okay. I'll just take some questions up there. Internet also about fine. Okay. How to remain ambitious while advancing Krishna consciousness? As we know, when we become sattvic, we get a detached from material nature. Do not be ambitious. If I become ambitious to become a great prisoner in a prison, will I ever want to get out of the prison? So that's the whole point. But if you chant Hare Krishna nicely. And it's amazing. You see, he is asking this question with his realization that when he becomes sattvic, he becomes detached from material world.
Yes.
So what do you want? It seems he's confused. He wants to get out of the world, but he wants to be in the world. So what do you want to do? You understand the point? Question hai ki bhai sattvik hote to hum detached ho jate hain. So that's a fact. When you chant Hare Krishna nicely, you will become detached from material world, and we are supposed to be detached from the material world. So a devotee, actual devotee, should earn that much money so that he can carry out his business properly, means his bhakti properly. Otherwise, 10 hours you work for outside company, what you can think of Krishna? Okay, so it is difficult to advance in that way. Even the sincere sweeper on the street is working for money. Could you explain why Prabhupada put this statement here? You see, a sincere sweeper is acting, sincere means, he is acting as per his adhikar. If he is a sweeper, by his conditioned nature, the sweeper, he behaves like a sweeper. What is prescribed for him? Obviously, Karma Yoga does not mean that you can't earn money. Did we ever said that? No. But you are not only working for money. A person works for money so that he can execute Krishna consciousness, because he needs some Lakshmi for also doing bhakti. It's not everybody is not a Babaji. Or even a Paramahansa. I'm also not a Paramahansa. Nobody is a Paramahansa here. Nobody means at least those whom we know. So we need some Lakshmi obviously in this world, but that should be only to facilitate our bhakti, not for sense enjoyment. So this person who is a sincere sweeper may be obviously working for money, but when he is chanting Hare Krishna, he is not chanting Hare Krishna for money. Nesamudra? Our sweeper in our temple, but Guga, he is also a devotee, he chants Hare, he cannot chant, speak, but he speaks in his mind Hare Krishna. So he may work for money, but not necessarily that he is a charlatan meditator, so to speak. It does not do like that. Our devotees are there in working devotee kitchen. They work for some basic Lakshmi, but they also chant Hare Krishna. Okay. It is said that good sadhana gives us detachment, but then in Gita it is said that a pure devotee loves everyone and everyone loves him. So how detachment brings love? He is detached from material sense gratification. But a devotee loves everybody on the platform of spirituality, seeing everybody as part and parcel of Krishna. We must remember, attachment to Krishna brings detachment. So if you are attached to Krishna, you will be attached to anything which is related to Krishna. So we can see everyone in relationship with Krishna, we offer love to them, but we are not attached to their material bodies. And in that, because of that kind of attachment, a person will give up his duties, is it not? So that is the point. How should we deal with Mayavadis or impersonalist Muslims? Well, it depends how advanced you are. Better to avoid in the beginning, because they may just preach you instead of trying to preach to them. Better to preach to those people who are innocent, who are in a mood of acceptance of bhakti. Most of the time we try to preach to them, we try to fight with them, is it not? And Mahaprabhu himself was avoiding. So just avoid them. Inke dimag mein kuch ghusta nahi hai. If somebody is eager to hear, whether it is a Muslim or impersonalist or whatever, then we can preach to them. And otherwise, they can accept prasadam, we can give them prasadam, or with loud chanting of Hare Krishna, they can hear Hare Krishna, they can purify. We are not hating them, but if they are not interested, then what is the point of speaking to them? To stay in Krishna consciousness, if our changing is perfect, Krishna makes arrangements for us to stay in Krishna consciousness. Yes, we should have a desire that I want to be Krishna conscious. Then Krishna will all make all the rhythms. You have any questions?
When we are doing counseling, at that time, we find some people who just say we can attend the morning classes, but we don't have the time in
evening classes. Okay.
So we can, when we get time, we can just hear the
recording. That is also there. Some people say that we have time in the morning for the morning program, but not in the evening program. So what you should tell? Okay. Best is to have both morning and evening, is it not? We have time for breakfast and we also time for dinner, or we don't have time for dinner also? Vikaras, but very important. Dinner is very important. The evening program will charge you for the morning program. The morning program will charge you all throughout the day. It's up to us. I don't know how you felt. I was so much charged. Same thing will happen today also. I'll hear something and I'll relish so much. Then again, I'll sleep till 11 p.m. or something like that. Maharaj class, so nice. Even when I was giving class, if I go till 9:30 or 9 a.m., then till 10:30, I will not be able to sleep. But Krishna consciousness really purifies you, especially. This evening program is very powerful. Anyhow, those who are not so intelligent, what you can do? But those who are really intelligent, they should have this program where they can actually do both morning and evening program. Okay? Dinner and breakfast. So we should stop here. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Tai Gaur Premanande. Kuch kar rahe the?